Hello students, now let us discuss the Dalton's law of partial pressure. Okay, we already came across what Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro law, Kirchhoff's law, combined glass gas law, and what Graham's law of diffusion. Okay, now let us discuss Dalton's law of partial pressure. Okay, before going to discuss Dalton's law of partial pressure, we should know the word. What is the definition of partial pressure? This is very very important. Okay, first you should be clear about the what is the partial pressure definition. Okay, now what is the here partial pressure is means what? Okay, in a mixture of gases, the pressure exerted by the individual gas is called partial pressure. Now what is the meaning of that one? Okay, let's see here. So what is the pressure means? Here you are talking the pressure in the mixture of gases. For example, okay, for example, I have the gas here. So for example, I have the gas, first gas and second gas in the vessel second and third gas in the third vessel. Okay, we have the three gases in different. Okay, now what happened? This gas exerts some pressure. Okay, this also has some pressure P, this also have P. Okay, now what happened? All the gases I am taking in the one vessel, that is first gas, second gas, third gas. Okay, so now in this, you know very well, once gas is there means they have some pressure. Okay, now in the mixture, here in the mixture, the pressure exerted by the gases is called as what? Partial pressure, not the individual. Okay, you should be very careful here. What happened in the individual, they have the pressure. Okay, fine, but if you go further in the mixture, okay, in the mixture each gas has some pressure, that is called as what? Partial pressure. Now what is the given here? In a mixture of gases, the pressure exerted by the individual gas is called partial pressure. So in the mixture, you are talking about the what? Individual gas going to exert some pressure. That pressure is called as a what? Partial pressure. Okay, now let us discuss the Dalton's law of partial pressure. Okay, what is the given here? The total, here we have the total pressure. Okay, so what happened in the mixture? So what happened in this mixture, have the some, for example, this gas having the partial pressure, I'm assuming as a P1, and this gas I'm assuming as a partial pressure P2, this gas as a P3. Now here, for this total vessel, how much the total pressure means? We have this is the total pressure. So total pressure equal to what? Sum of the partial pressure. So you are going to add all the partial pressure, you are getting the total pressure. So now what is here, you should be very careful in the problem also, are they giving total pressure or partial pressure? Okay, in the mixture, the pressure exerted by the gas is called as a partial pressure. Now if you go further, add the all the pressure together, you are getting the P total. Okay, now what is the definition here? The total pressure exerted by a mixture of chemically non-reacting gases at a given temperature and volume is equal to the sum of the partial pressure of the component gases. What is that one here? Okay, so we are taking the mixture of gases. Okay, now what happened? They should be chemically non-reacting. So what happened? I took the 1, 2, 3 gases. Okay, they should be what? Chemically non-reacting means what? They should not react together. For example, if I take H2 and Cl2, H2 plus Cl2, what happened? If you go for the high pressure, they are going to react and give the HCl. So this is about reacting gases. So we should not take the reacting gases, we should take the non-reacting gases. For example, neon, oxygen is there. So what happened here? Neon is noble gases, it's not going to be reacted with the oxygen. So we have to take the non-reacting gases, not the chemically reacting gases should not be taken. So here what happened? The total pressure exerted by a mixture of chemically non-reacting gases at given temperature and volume. So for each law, we have some variables constant. In this, we have the variable what? Temperature and volume is constant. Okay, that is equal to what? Sum of the partial pressure of the component gases. Now if you see the mathematical here, what happened? P total means total pressure equal to P1 means partial pressure of first gas, partial pressure of second gas, partial pressure of third gas, if you take here, so on, and depends on your number of gases. Here, what is the conditions here? At constant temperature and volume. Okay, for each law, we have some variable constant. So here constant what? Temperature and volume. So this is the what means the partial pressure is equal to what? The total pressure is equal to sum of the partial pressure at constant temperature and volume. Okay, this is the what? Dalton's law of partial pressure. Now see some explanation. Okay, consider a mixture of three gases in a vessel. Okay, you have to consider now three gases are there. For the three gases, okay, now assume there partial pressure what? Here P1, P2 and P3. Okay, just now we assume we took the three gases, their partial pressure we are assuming as a what? P1, P2 and P3. Now let P1, P2, P3 are the partial pressure of the three gases in the mixture. We are taking the what? We took the mixture. In the mixture we have the three gases. In the mixture we will take the word, use the word partial pressure. The partial pressure is what? P1, P2 and P3. Now according to Dalton's law of partial pressure, the total pressure, nothing but P total of the gas, is equal to sum of the partial pressure of the component gases at a given temperature. So what is the, this is the what? P total equal to sum of the P1 plus P2 and P3. Okay, now so nothing but that P total equal to P1 plus P2, P3. So what we did here, we took the three gases, assuming as a now A, B, C instead of 1, 2, 3. For this A gas, partial pressure is P1. For this P2, P3 is the partial pressure. Now let us discuss for this number of moles of this gas is N1 and for this gas what? N2 and this what? N3. Now P total how much? If you go for the sum all P1 plus P2 plus P3, you are getting the total pressure. And our condition is what? Here value mind temperature is same. Okay, now next go for, if you see next, let N1, N2, N3 are the number of moles of the three gases respectively in the mixture. Let V be the V, nothing but volume, the volume of the mixture of the gas at a temperature T Kelvin. Okay, now these are the volume, at the volume and temperature, these are the three gases having the partial pressure P1, P2, P3 respectively and number of moles N1, N2, N3 respectively. Now if you apply the ideal gas equation for the each gas, okay, what is the ideal gas equation? We have PV equal to nRT, isn't it? Now if you apply the first gas, for the first gas if you apply the ideal gas equation, what? PV equal to nRT means if you go for the rearrangement, if you bring the V here, P1 equal to N1 RT by V. Okay, for second gas also P2 equal to N2 RT by V. For third gas P3 equal to what? N3 RT by V, isn't it? So what happened in this case? Volume is same and temperature is same. What is our condition here? Volume and temperature is same. So for all three gases, volume and temperature is same. Okay, you know very well R is the universal gas constant. For each gas is a constant, so there is no variation. So total here R by TV is the common for the three gases. Okay, now our according to Dalton's law, what here? P total pressure of the mixture, nothing but P total equal to sum of the P1 plus P2 P3. Okay, these are the what? Partial pressure of three gases. Now if I substitute here, if you want the P total means what happened? I have to add the all the pressure. Now P1 how much we have? N1 RT V by divided by V. Now P2 how much we have? Plus N2 RT by V. P3 how much is there? N3 RT by V. Okay, now if you go for the P total here, RT by V is common. If you go for the common here, so what you left into N1 plus N2 plus N3. Okay, now I am dividing P1 by P total. So what is this one here? We have the P1. This is what? P total. Now what I am doing? P1 divided with the P total. So P1 what we have here? N1 RT by V, isn't it? Okay, N1 RT by V. Now here P2 how much we have? N1 plus N2 plus N3 RT by V. So this RT by V, RT by this RT by V, RT by V. Okay, for both the cases RT by V common, so it's going to be get cancelled. You left with the one N1 by N1 plus N2 plus N3. Now what we have? P1 by P total equal to N1 by N1 plus N2 plus N3. This total number of mole I'm assuming as about N. Okay, now what happened? N1 by N, this I'm total assuming as a equal to X1. X1 means what? Here this is a mole fraction of the first gas. What is the mole fraction here? Mole fraction means here, if you go for definition, number of moles of first, whatever you're taking the individual gas by total number of moles, if you divide with the total number of moles, you are getting the mole fraction. Okay, so here what happened? If x1 is what? Mole fraction of the first gas. So Here what happened here if you see x1 means nothing but here mole fraction definition how can you define number of moles of the first gas divided with the total number of moles in the mixture of gases that is called as a mole fraction. Now we have the relation if you go for the simplification what happened here P1 by P total if you go for total here what happened mole fraction isn't it P1 by P total equal to x1 nothing but this is what P1 means what partial pressure equal to what mole fraction into P total. So we have the formula what is here. Similarly if you go for the partial pressure of second gas P2 equal to mole fraction of that gas x2 into P total. Next partial pressure of third gas P3 equal to what mole fraction of that gas into P total. So thus a general equation can be written as here what partial pressure okay nothing but Pi equal to mole fraction of particular gas that is Xi into here what have happened we have the total pressure. So you should be very careful we have the partial pressure this is the partial pressure equal to mole fraction of particular gas into total pressure okay. So Pi Xi means what partial pressure and mole fraction of ith gas means you are assuming some I number of gases are there. Their gases we are assuming the one partial pressure and mole fraction okay. You should be very careful by doing the problems. This is a partial pressure this is a total pressure okay. This is the what here we have the what we discuss now Dalton's law of partial pressure. Now let us discuss numericals based on the what Dalton's law of partial pressure. Now if you go for the numericals what is the given there here. So come to the numericals here we have the okay problem number if you go for the problem number 4.6 here we have the numericals based on the Gram's law of Dalton's law of partial pressure. Here what is the given a neon dioxygen mixture contains 70.6 grams of dioxygen and 167.5 grams of neon okay. So what happened here we have the neon dioxygen and their mass is how much given 70.6 grams for dioxygen 167.5 grams of neon okay. If the pressure of the mixture of gases in the cylinder is 25 bar mean this is 25 bar means what here total pressure of the cylinder how much here 25 bar. Now what is the partial pressure of dioxygen and neon in the mixture. Now what is the given here so what is the data given here okay we have one cylinder in that we have the neon is there dioxygen is there okay. So if you go for the for neon how much we have the mass here 70.6 grams for the oxygen how much we have 167.5 grams okay. So what happened here they given the P total how much total given how much we have 25 bar given okay. Now what is here asking partial pressure of neon is how much partial pressure of oxygen is how much they are asking about the what partial pressure of neon partial pressure of oxygen. So but total pressure given okay we know very well P total equal to what sum of the partial pressure of neon partial pressure of oxygen okay. Here already 25 bar given if you know any one you can come to know another one but what happened we don't know the partial pressure of neon we don't know the partial pressure of oxygen. So if you found any one you can find out the another one because already why because means we have the P total given. Now let us go for the solution okay. Now so now here you should be very careful what is the given total pressure how much we have 25 bar is there. Now we have the two gases oxygen neon okay. So this is already we discussed in Dalton's law of partial pressure we have to take the what non-reacting gases. So if you take here neon oxygen they are not going to react together. Now mass of oxygen already given how much they given 70.6 grams. Now molar mass of oxygen how much here you have to come to know default that is how much 32 gram per mole okay. No one will tell you how to remember. Next for neon molar mass how much here mass how much given 167.5 grams. Now molar mass of neon how much here 20 grams per mole you have to remember default okay. Now what is our question here what is the partial pressure of oxygen how much what is the partial pressure of neon how much. So what happened here we have the relation partial pressure of oxygen equal to what mole fraction of oxygen into P total okay. So you can calculate the partial pressure of oxygen or partial pressure of neon if you know the mole fraction of oxygen or neon. Here what happened? Already P total given. Okay. If you know the mole fraction of oxygen, we can come to know the what? Partial pressure of oxygen we can come to know. But now what question is what? How you are going to find out the mole fraction of oxygen? Okay, now find out the mole fraction of oxygen. If you substitute here, P total already given. If you multiply together, you will get the partial pressure of oxygen. So first our task is what? We have to find out the mole fraction of oxygen here. Now, so mole fraction means, what is the definition of mole fraction here? Mole fraction means what? Number of moles of which gas you are finding out in oxygen. Oxygen by divided with the what? Total number of moles of all the gases. So we have what? Two gases. One is oxygen, one is neon. So this is a formula of to calculate the mole fraction of particular gas. So for this what happened? Now you have to find out the number of moles of oxygen, number of moles of neon. Now let us find out the number of moles of oxygen. How much? What is the formula here? Number of moles, what is the formula? We have the mass by molar mass, isn't it? Mass already we have how much? 70.6 grams. Molar mass how much? 32 grams per mole. So what happened here? Gram, grams get cancelled. You left with the number of moles of oxygen how much? 2.21 moles, okay? But here what happened? We have to find out the mole fraction of oxygen. We got the number of moles, but we have to find out the mole fraction of oxygen. So mole fraction of oxygen means we need the mole fraction of what? Neon also we need. Already we got the number of moles of oxygen we got here. But now we have to find out the number of moles of neon. Okay. So let us find out the number of moles of neon. What is the formula of number of moles? Number of moles equal to mass by molar mass. Isn't it? Mass how much given here? 167.5 grams. Here 167.5 grams. Divided with the what? Here molar mass of neon how much? 20 grams per mole. So this gram will get cancelled. You left it with the how much? 8.375 moles. Okay. Now we have the number of moles of oxygen is there. Number of moles of neon is there. Now you can calculate the mole fraction of each gas. Now find out the mole fraction of oxygen. What is the formula? Mole fraction of oxygen equal to number of moles of oxygen divided with the number of moles of oxygen plus number of moles of neon. So number of moles of oxygen how much we have? 2.21. Now number of moles of here moles, okay, number of moles of oxygen 2.21, number of moles of neon how much we got here? 8.375 moles. Okay, if we go for simplification, how much we have? Number of moles of oxygen equal to 0.21. okay, now come to number of moles of neon. Okay, number of moles of neon means number of moles of neon here divided with the total number of moles of all the gases. So number of moles of neon divided with the number of moles of oxygen plus number of moles of neon. So number of moles of neon how much we have? 8.315 moles. Next, number of moles of oxygen how much we have? 2.21. and number of moles of neon how much we have? 8.375. if you go for the simplification, how much we have? Now mole fraction of neon equal to 0.77 grams. Okay, you can go 0.79. okay, now mole fraction does not have the units, by because means a fraction of mole, which is ratio of moles. Okay, now so we got the number of moles of, now mole fraction of oxygen, mole fraction of neon is there. Now instead of calculating like this, you generally always you have remember sum of the mole fraction of all the gases equal to what? 1. Okay, for example, already you know the neon. So neon, if you know here, you can if you know the oxygen, you can calculate the neon. How means here? Neon equal to, if you go for here, 1 minus the mole fraction of oxygen. So 1 minus mole fraction of oxygen how much we have? 0.21. okay, so here how much we got? 0.79. so if you know, if you go for sum together here, how much you are getting here? Equal to 1. So very very important, you can calculate the mole fraction individual like this, or if you know the one gas molar mass, you can calculate, if you know one gas mole fraction, you can calculate the mole fraction of another gas. Okay, here. So this you can use, depends on your need. So here what happened? Partial pressure of oxygen equal to what? Mole fraction of oxygen into P total. So mole fraction of oxygen how much we got? 0.21. so P total how much here? 25 bar already. Here we given the P total 25 bar already given. Now if you substitute here, we got the how much here? 5.25 bar. This is what? Partial pressure of oxygen. Now come to partial pressure of neon. What is the formula here? Mole fraction of neon into P total. So mole fraction of neon how much we have? 0.79. P total how much? 25 bar. So now partial pressure how much here? 19.75 bar. okay, Now let us check here. So our question, what they ask? Partial pressure of oxygen, partial pressure of neon. They ask, we got this much. Okay, now I got doubt, is it correct answer or not? Let us go for the cross checks here. So what happened? According to P total is what? Dalton law, partial pressure, P total equal to what? Partial pressure of oxygen, partial pressure of neon, isn't it? So here partial pressure of oxygen, how much we got? 5.25 bar. Neon, how much we got? 19.75 bar. If you add together, how much we are getting? 25 bar. So you can go for the cross checker, your answer, is it correct or not? So how much we got here total pressure? 25 bar. Okay, this is the problem based on the one Dalton's law of partial pressure. Okay, yeah, so you should be very careful in the data, what which pressure, partial pressure are they given, or P total are they given, and how to calculate the mole fraction of particular gas. Okay, so these are the very important problems for the exams also.